Hi, I'm Tricia, an organic gardener. I grow organically for a healthy and safe food supply, for a clean and sustainable environment, for an enjoyable and rewarding experience. Testing your soil is an important part of growing happy, healthy plants. Laboratory testing is really the most accurate way to test your soil, and it should be your starting point. But home kits are a great way to monitor the effects of your fertilization. The main nutrients plants need are nitrogen for vegetative growth, phosphorus for root and flower development, and potassium for vigor. Soil pH is the fourth important measurement because it determines whether or not a plant can use the available nutrients. For more information about the vital nutrients, what they do, and how to add them to your soil if you have a deficiency, watch our Fertilizing Organically video. Your soil test is only as good as your sample. To take a good sample, you want to use a clean stainless steel tool like a trowel. Or if you're doing a lot of sampling, you can get this soil sampler. For more information on taking a good soil sample and the type of testing a laboratory performs, check out our soil test video. Take several samples from a single area and go down about 6 to 8 inches in depth. And then mix the samples together. Avoid touching the soil with your bare hands. Put the soil in a clean plastic, stainless steel, or paper container. Do a soil test for each distinct area in your garden. For example, I'm going to do a separate soil test for each one of the raised beds. Spread the soil out on a sheet of dry paper and let it dry for about 12 hours. Don't try to hurry it along by putting it in the oven. Well, my soil is dry, and now it's time to start my test. Crush the soil and sift it through a sifter or a screen to get an even texture, and remove any debris or rocks. I'll be using the Lamotte Soil Test Kit. Be sure and read all the material safety data sheets and follow the instructions very closely. Some of the reagents can irritate your skin or eyes, so be sure and wear your gloves and your safety goggles. First, I'll do the pH test. Fill one of the test tubes to the fourth line with the pH indicator. Use the 0.5 gram spoon and add 3 scoops of soil. Put on the cap and shake gently for 1 minute. Just set the test tube down and let it settle for about 12 minutes. Now it's time to compare my pH to the color chart. To get an accurate reading of a color chart, stand with the sun behind you and hold the test tube about a half an inch in front of the color card. Looks like I have a pH of about 8.0. On to the nitrogen testing. Take a clean test tube and fill it to line 7 with the nitrogen extracting solution. And again, we're going to add 3 of these scoops, which are 0.5 grams each. Put on the cap and shake gently for 1 minute. Remove the cap and let it settle. Once it's settled, use a clean pipette to move the clear liquid to another clean test tube to line 3. Be careful not to pull up any soil. Add 2.25 gram scoops of the nitrogen indicator powder. Cap it, mix gently, and wait for a pink color to develop. My nitrogen test indicates that I have trace amounts of nitrogen. On to the phosphorus test. Fill up the test tube to line 6 with the phosphorus extracting solution. Put in 3 scoops of 0.5 grams of soil. Gently shake and let settle. Once it's settled, use a clean pipette to move the clear liquid to another clean test tube to line 3. Add 6 drops of phosphorus indicator reagent. Cap and mix. Then add 1 phosphorus tablet. Be careful not to touch the tablet. Mix until the tablet dissolves and the liquid turns blue. Well, looks like I have plenty of phosphorus. The last nutrient I'm going to test is the potassium. Fill a clean test tube to line 7 with the potassium extracting solution. This time, for the potassium, we're going to add 4 scoops, and then we're going to shake vigorously, not gently. Again, allow it to settle and move it to a clean test tube with a pipette. It needs to be filled to line 5, so you might have to prepare more soil. Add a potassium indicator tablet and mix gently until the tablet dissolves and the liquid turns purple. Add the potassium solution 1 drop at a time. Mix in between the drops and keep track of how many you put in. Stop adding drops when the liquid turns from purple to blue. I had to add 25 drops to get the potassium color light blue. I'm really low on potassium. Fortunately, the Lamott Soil Test Kit comes with three fantastic guides that you can read to determine what to do next in amending your soil. So do a soil test and grow organic for life.